Good Wednesday evening. A few areas saw some showers and storms a little bit earlier today. Picked up about 0.4 inches just across that western side of BCS. Some heavier rain amounts as you get across eastern parts of the Brazos Valley. Some areas picked up around 1 inch of rain, but it was really spotty in nature. Still dealing with some of that activity out there right now across northeastern parts of the Brazos Valley. Here in BCS, though, just dealing with a little bit of cloud cover. No rain activity out there right now. Across the state, some isolated to scattered storms across a large part of Texas. The eastern parts of the state, as well as out across southern parts of the Texas Panhandle, dealing with some of the activity, and it's keeping temperatures on the cool side where it is raining. 85 degrees in Lubbock, 86 in Midland. Those temperatures would be in the triple digits if they weren't dealing with any thunderstorm activity. 100 in Laredo, 100 in Del Rio. So some areas still dealing with some of those summer-like temperatures. Taking a look at the future radar, there is a chance for some isolated storms heading into tomorrow. Most areas going to remain dry, though, but the coverage of showers and storms is around 10%. So I can't rule out one or two storms when we add in that daytime heating. There's just nothing creating any lift to generate widespread showers and storms. Still monitoring this tropical low out over central parts of the Gulf of Mexico. The hurricane hunters are in it right now, and they're evaluating it, saying it has 35-mile-per-hour winds sustained, and it is working its way off toward the west at about 8 miles per hour. Now, this hasn't been classified as a depression or a storm yet, but we are expecting the possibility of it developing into a storm over the next couple of days. We'll take a look at that here in just a second. Now, models are showing it's going to start working its way off toward the west northwest. Each one of these lines represents a model run, and the consensus is somewhere from Freeport down to Corpus Christi is where this is going to make landfall, and it is going to impact the Brazos Valley. Taking a look at the odds of development, around 80% as we head throughout the week, and it's gradually going to work off toward the west northwest, approaching that Texas coast. So the development chances are extremely high with the system. The reason why is we have warm ocean temperatures out there, mid to upper 80s across the Gulf of Mexico, and the wind shear. There's no wind shear out across the Gulf, and that's going to allow this storm to really start to organize as it continues to tap in to those warm waters across central parts of the Gulf. Now, as we head into Friday morning, it should be a tropical system at this point, a depression or a storm off of that Texas coast. So it's going to be chilling out there Friday morning. Heading into Friday evening, notice it's still just spinning out along coastal parts of Texas. Could start to scrape that middle part of the coast as we head toward Friday night. Eastern side of the storm going to see some of the heavy showers and storms. We're going to see some of the activity wrap into the Brazos Valley as well. And then as we head into Saturday, the system going to kind of slow down over southern parts of the state, and it could dump some really heavy rain as it tries to stall out there. Taking a look at the rain chances, they really increase late Friday into Saturday. That's where we're going to see our best chance for some showers and storms. How much rain are we looking at? Well, there's going to be a really tight gradient from northern parts of the Brazos Valley down into the southern part. Northern zone could only pick up about 0.5 inch of rain, while that southern zone picks up around 4 inches. Now, keep in mind, any deviation in that path to the north could pull these higher rain totals north. Or if it tracks farther south, well, we could just see a few drops of rain. So we're going to have to continue to monitor that over the next 12 to 24 hours. And it's not only a rain threat. There will be some enhanced wind, especially across the upper and mid Texas coast as we head into late Friday. This is going to be around 10 to 11 p.m. on Friday as it tries to work its way toward land. We're going to see some gusty winds here in the Brazos Valley with some of the squalls. 20 to 30 mile per hour wind gusts, a possibility. Stronger wind gusts, though, as you get a little bit farther south into the coastal parts of Texas. Taking a look at that 10-day forecast, we do see those temperatures come down with the increase in rain. We should see highs in the 80s, Gabrielle and Tristan, so we will take that. That's the good news with seeing that rain.
That is good news, but you mentioned winds. Does anybody here have to, you know, take a little bit of extra precautions or just be prepared, like house-wise or things like that with the wind?
No, we're just going to see gusts 20 to 30 miles per hour with some of the squalls. Nothing too impactful. Could break a couple twigs. If it moves a little farther north, there could be an increased hazard if it intensifies, but right now it's mainly a rain threat. But as you get toward coastal parts of Texas, as you get toward Freeport, as well as Victoria, Corpus Christi, that's where there could be some 60 or 70 mile per hour wind gust.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Christopher.
Well, sports is next. Justin Behan with your sports. Stay tuned.